Today I am joined by Walter. Walter, my brother, welcome to the show. Please introduce yourself to those who don't know you.
Thank you so much, Impilo. For those who don't know me, I'm actually humbled to be on your platform once more. I've been on your platform, I think, last year, I believe. I also have a platform of my own on YouTube. If guys are interested, obviously, in the content, they can also check me out, on my platform. It's called Touchline. It also covers your football content, local football. And obviously, it's just about enhancing the conversation. Yeah. So that's why I'm a podcaster of my heart, and I'm also a football lover covering Izinto Zebhola. So that's who I am in a nutshell.
All right. So you guys go check the channel out. I'm linking here so that you can also just go check out the Touchline. Now, Walter, indaba enkulu.
Sure.
It's fair to say that the Chiefs getting destroyed by Yanga, as much as it was a friendly, it raised not a few concerns. I think that would be an understatement. But one thing that Nabi said after that game, which I found to be very interesting, is that he said that we have to find players of quality. I'm paraphrasing him. And in saying that, he said that he will not say that in front of the media because he's respectful of his players, right? So when you look at that Kaizer Chiefs squad, which place or which area do you think needs quality, in your opinion?
Hey, the fan in me could say each and every department, but another side, obviously me being a lover of the game, I wouldn't want to disrespect. I wouldn't say each and every department is entirely bad. But, you know, I think what we are forgetting as well is that maybe there's a sentiment of us looking at the squad. And I was thinking about it in this past week, obviously looking at the Yanga game and where we come from, and you're looking at the tweets and you go to spaces and people are very worried. But I think also the timing is maybe because of the fact that we are still in the era of last season, right? Mm-hmm. And that's why it feels like the 4-0, it's such a big thing, and it's more or less the same thing after 9 years, after bad coaches that we have attracted to our club. So there's a lot of concern, and the nerves now are starting to kick in again. Feels like it's nostalgia. Now, they always feel like back to the same old ways. But if we were to be honest, I don't think all areas of concern or positions should be stressed that much, because remember, if we are planning, because obviously what we know about Unabi, he loves young players. So if we are planning to be able to use or reserve those positions for young players, I wouldn't say necessarily let's rush into signing each and every player in every department. But areas of concern is left back.
This is not just from the fans. It's also from Unabi himself saying he needs quality. So maybe I should paraphrase my point and say, what do you think he's talking about? Which positions do you think he's talking about? And obviously, that will be influenced by what you think.
Well, look, central back, obviously, I think the Yanga game, as much as it's still very fresh, but probably because he's been with the club in Turkey, he's realized that maybe having Simangi having a backup central back maybe could be something we can look into. And we saw that maybe go right back also, apart from Mofros, I don't think it's going to be Zungu Solomons. That's my hunch. I don't know. But that defense, there's a lot of makeshift that we have to make there. Because obviously, let's say, for example, we have Dove, we have Usem, but probably that's where we should start. Because obviously, we can't talk about the goalkeeping department because we've already done something about that. And wings. On the wings, we do need to beef up there, and obviously adding a striker. So to answer you directly, it would be maybe one defender for now, even though we need, maybe moving forward, we'll need to add there. Two wingers, both sides, and one striker.
So with the Solomon's issue, what makes you think that Solomon's might not play under Unabi? Because I've heard some complaints as well about Ufrosla. So what makes you think on that right back position it can happen? Because if I'm being honest, Guyana Ufrosla seems like he has not been himself since Gavin Hunt left the Chiefs. I think he's had moments, but he's not had like a consistent run of form where he just played well.
And that's true. I guess maybe if we're to look at the games or the amount of, because visually the only evidence that you have is that Yanga game. Yeah? But obviously behind closed doors, those games that we're playing, it's just that we don't know the inside. I'm using my hunch in saying, lo Solomon's in Mbugele last season, I wasn't quite impressed. In terms of, to me, Solomon's, Dupree, Saile have one thing in common, and they don't know how to use their speed. So, Makichi manje aimless. So, Ufosla obviously has a right back, as we saw with Tibam Ketile. I think for me, that was the advice that the technical team took into account. Looking at him, Gutivele, he's always been our first choice right back. He's versatile, he can either play on the left and also on the right. So, there's lots of attributes that suggests that Ufosla may just be the person they are willing to work with. Because Umbonile Manjite Nkazile is that he's not only just flicking the ball, Amanashai helicopter. So there's an improvement in his game, just in one game. So Usolomon's Guti Banga to the chance in the second half. And I don't know what we
are saying. Oh, Solomon's
sorry. Yeah. Okay. Ah, man. Okay, so my point won't be as strong until he comes back to fitness. Yeah. So it won't be that strong. But maybe it's my personal feat, but let's see what the technical team may decide. But I'm just, maybe it's just me not liking it, but based on what I've seen.
You're not the only one. Notando and I were saying the same thing.
Yeah, I would say, there's a lot of things, Solomon, that I think are not developed in Alice Kati or any Asian ways at. And remember, there's a lot of quality. I want to get back to the first question. There's a lot of quality also in the market in terms of locally, Namudino, Muntes Nampega, and other people outside. So we don't have time, I feel, as an FC, which is made about Solomon Gustiba developing. Name to understand development. I bafang even in the end. So that's my assessment. Because I think we have a sober technical team match. So actually, let's move on. And this probably you can work with Forsla until we have a proper pickup. So that's how I see it for myself.
Okay, ngiyakuzwa mina ngiyohlezi ngimdefend uSolomonzo wabantu kodwa ngizoyeka leyo for now. I won't be fighting for him because I know a lot of people abamfeel, but he's one of those players that I think even uSayile, like yabo uSayile mina ngamdefenda ngithi he has a potential of being lethal. Yabona, because uSayile the biggest problem is if you can fix his final touch. Like the final thing, because Usaile will run past 7 people. I'm not exaggerating, but he can dribble, he can body people. But the final decision is what kills him. And that is why I feel like if you can fix that with Usaile, because he can dribble, he has pace, and he's a big boy. I feel like if you can just work on what he does with the ball in the end, he can be deadly.
If I were to also rebuttal, I would say at a big club like Kaizer Chiefs, that's why we continue having problems in our season. If you're going to attract a foreign player, that remember when you're buying a foreign player, you must have what you don't have. So if we have a Dupree that has the same problem as Saile, what are we doing? We've spent on that guy. Keep him hard. Is that no? We want to bring quality or a different element to our game, probably that we couldn't find. Our scouting team probably couldn't find locally here. And that spot is reserved for that. So he comes with this a certain profile. He's an international. He has promoted his own club to the second division in Congo. He's young. Do you understand? He's less than 25 years old. We're expecting that development to be there. But if it's not there and we bought it, it's not like we went to Zimbabwe, we did a buy one, plus one kind of thing. We actually went out and bought this play. So if he has those attributes that you are actually defending him on, that's where the problem is. That's why I would say he wouldn't be in my books as a player, because now that means we have to reserve all other players and at a big club that demands so much that has to win each and every game. That's why maybe okay, bring him on, sell 15 minutes, 10 minutes, and all that. But I wouldn't be a player that I'm saying I'm chasing honors. But we have to win in the season. Something has to happen. But if we're waiting for him to realize with Ntwana, take the technical team and teach him that thing. So that's a big question. I hear you. But on my side, I wouldn't just bank on a foreigner to have those kind of mistakes. If it was a local player like Dupree, I would have agreed with you. So I mean that's where Mkampe Nibanikinga Nyana would be, oh, but come on, guys. An international player at our club.
No, Nyaguz, and you have a valid point, Velugutti. The biggest thing with foreign players is that they are taking up that foreign spot, and we could be utilizing that on a really deadly player. So if you have a foreign player who's not, because ideally foreign players, all of them that we sign should be like starters, people who are going to come in and make an immediate difference. And yeah, but because you don't go outside the country if you have that thing in South Africa, that means you thought it wasn't in SA and you went to find it outside. So if Mfundo can trap the ball better, can decide better than Saile, then yeah, I get your point. I really do. Now let's talk about this thing, because I just brought up Mfundo and you were talking about this. Ukamondi said something about Chiefs. He said, and he was very bold, and people were not happy about this. He's like, you're playing young kids. You can't do that if you want to win. I'm paraphrasing him again, but he was referring to international football and playing young kids, and you need experience, because and you're a big team. And if you're in a big team, there's no excuse that you're a kid. You should be performing, because there's an expectation that you are playing for this team. So we see Usamgelo, and I want people to hear us. We're not trying to criticize these boys and say they suck, but we're looking at the comments of a coach who did beat Chiefs and is coaching a team that was going to beat Sundowns, but then they got robbed of the Champions League and won the league, and it's just basically coaching a good team. What do you make of that? Because there are mistakes that I sit here and defend Usamgelo Zwane and say he's just trying to impress the crowd. I defend Umtu and say he's trying to impress the crowd. He's a young kid. He's going to learn. So how much lenience and how many excuses can we make for them? How much excuses can we make for them, given that people are expecting the team to win?
Yeah, no, that's a very, and I'm glad you mentioned, that's a very important point, because obviously, at Lapine too, there's a culture that we have to still protect. And also, I never spoke too much, but obviously maintaining a certain standard at the very same time. I want to be controversial, because I want to defend Mfundo, even if I were to agree with, even though Stephen Aziz Key, I don't know if you saw his interview as well,
he said Mfundo dribbling is nonsense.
It's nonsense. But hold on. Remember, Tina, this is our culture, right? Dribbling is not something that's foreign to us. The only thing any understander, right, probably they're saying, okay, let's start with the Kamondi comment. For me, I want to disagree with him, because when I was watching him in City in the past, I realized one thing, which is what Lukunya, our coach, said. It's a friendly at the end of the day, whether it's a sold-out crowd or not. Number two, for me, that's funny enough, a lot of people will just bash me, it's fine. But I think Unabi is a strategist in a sense where, for now, we don't even know his starting lineup side. The coach says you can't field six young players in a friendly like this, in a match like this, because obviously showing us their quality, they are Tanzanian champions, they come with a cap profile, whatever. But I respect Unabi even more, because we don't even know now his lineup, right? So we don't know how he's going to move. Is he going to use Umtuduzi the same way he used him in that lineup? Or probably he has a different idea, or like he said, he's still assessing these young boys. So in the Mfundo, the only time I'm in protecting are you, express yourself, minus players, like what Samkelo was trying to do, make the mistake when you are really doing something, you're on boot. But we, at the same time, Tina, we you know, when you teach the boy, how you please the crowd, because if the score was 2-0 for us, we wouldn't be talking about him. Do you understand? So I guess it's happy because when I'm trying to come here and understand, it's part of our football. The only thing Mfana Simboni is to learn from about Simba, so anyway, they dance on the ball progressively, going forward, minusing players, tactically understanding where they are. So that you understand, but Mfana Mfana. And remember what another comment that Baruna Ute, I will do the best I can to add quality to this club without sacrificing the culture. Do you understand? So
one yes, of man, I was sorry, Gangan. The point here is not Aziz's point wasn't. Or now you are talking about Kamondi because Aziz wasn't talking about. Okay, because when eating Abuelu Guti, Aziz and I was criticizing. Dribbling while the score is 1-0, we are losing.
Yes.
I mean, the flick and you know, so that was the thing that he was saying, because I've seen some people saying, oh, but Mfundo was creating space for himself, and I'm like, I'm pretty sure Mfundo could have figured out another way of creating space for himself, which was not regarded as, what's the word, showboating. But no, continue, because you're talking about Ukamund.
I was just responding to the comment yaga Kamundi, where I differ. That's why I said I want to be controversial. But when we're moving to yaga Stephen Aziz, I can't disagree with that. He's quite right in that instance, where that's where the immaturity and having young players comes in, I guess. Where if you had an experienced player who can still showboat, they wouldn't do it when it's 1-0 down. I'm sorry. But remember that time, Nakona, maybe there's a bit of, because it's a friend, we don't know which is woman, but no, express yourself, it's a friendly, enjoy, and all these things. And I remember from them, they're thinking psychologically, when you do those things, obviously we're trying to intimidate. Because if you remember that section of play, for the last 15 minutes, that's where we are still penetrating, we're still trying to connect, and stuff like that. So obviously, that's why I'm saying I'm putting 2 points where it's a positive and a negative. Because I totally agree with you, Steven Aziz. But Jaka Kamondi, I wouldn't necessarily ngihambisane naye kakhulu, because obviously, probably bona bayithatha serious. But Tina, we're in a different start point where we're still assessing our squad. So whether it's a sold-out game or not, it's still a friendly at the end of the day. It's an unofficial match. And abafana fanele banikezwe the room to make mistakes as much as I can. I understand about banikezwe a show routine. But in the long run, it will, I believe, ngendlela right in a seven. So, yeah, that's my 2 cents.
Guys, if you are enjoying, by the way, please do make sure to subscribe to the channel. And remember to go check out Touchline, no Walter Lab.
Touchline.
And subscribe with the Walter as well. So, yeah, so now my other question now is, so how do we balance this? Because we want to have enough quality, right? But at the same time, we want to win, right? Because as much as Mfundo, because Mfundo for me, like he's a, like no one starts ahead of him in that right wing position. In fact, I will also go as far as to say the starting 11 that Nabi started, with an exception of a left back, because Umbutu is not even a left back. He was just put there as a makeshift because he's a left winger, actually. I would say the starting 11, with an exception of Umbutu and probably the keeper, because I think Untuar is going to be a starter because he's better with playing and building up from the back than Peterson and Vum. So I think only those two people are not part of Nabi's starting 11. So now the question is, do you start all three, Samgelo, Mfundo, and Mdu, do you start all of them if you are Nabi against Gallants?
No. I would start with, I will build a team around Uzwane, because I feel like Nati FCH has been very, very too harsh on the boy to such an extent where there's only a few games where we can criticize the boy. If you remember, there was a game last year where he started, I think, no, the previous season where Mangete was still in charge against Sekhukhune, where he had a very, very good game. Stellenbosch, but you can't really trace it. So there is a bit of quality there. So I would start him. Castillo at one end, Nomar, since Spanish at time to time. Then I would let Umduduzi and Umfundo compete for the same position. I say this because having both of them sharp, Ngaba Indlela, and for other games to experiment. But you have to instill the hunger in these boys because you don't want to give them too much card with because Bangashala is cool. So when you make them compete for the same position, you're keeping them on their toes, and each and every game will give you consistent performances, I believe. But each and every position now was a sacrifice. Mina now must come on side, it won't make any difference because primarily all these guys are young players. So I would let some kind of play because already he's going to be next to experienced players, which, like, for instance, for example, I still believe in Umtata or Castillo. Then must know. Then in that, obviously, we have Ngobo and everyone else that we can put in other positions. But these two, Mfundo, Shabalala, I would let them compete. And that's our bias. Just be honest with them. Omo into the first half was 75 minutes, Omo into 35. So that they can also work for those minutes. There's no free lunch in Kaizer Chiefs. So if we can have, I believe Nabi is that kind of winner. They need to start working for that thing. Not because where would you see automatically you are the star in the future of the club. No. If you don't perform, leave. So I think that's where we can start maybe doing things. Because no, Nabi is very clear. I mean, for me, I believe in that guy. And what I love is the thing that we start to talk about, I believe you're going to start seeing. Where they're going to start making. Remember what he said, which you need to start assessing the squad without emotions. I love that thing.
Since Unabi said that he wants to assess the quality of the squad without any emotions, which players do you think that Kaizer Chiefs fans have that emotional attachment that they don't want to be touched? Because, for example, no one is talking about how much Dupri ghosted this weekend, and yet he did. Everyone else is talking about every other player, but no one is starting to pray. Which other player do things like that? Maybe give me three.
If I were to mention three, Ngobo, number one.
Kosengiphile.
Kosengiphile. Ay, I'm fine. Mart. Good Lord. Mm-hmm. This guy. And obviously, are we talking about specifically the game or in general, all the players that we have now?
In general, all the players we have.
All the players we have. Okay, good. Hi. Okay, I think I have a goalkeeper. But it would be most of the DTC players. So, Mina, for me, but I just wanted to name Abantu who are part of Usabe. We have Abantu who are more part of the squad list, like for example, players that
you can mention them,
but let me mention those players for the sake of our conversation. Umvuma, for example, we still have an attachment there. We don't want to move on from the boy because he's been pretty jerked though. And also, sorry, Peter, just at this point, I think also, obviously, the biggest elephant in the room, maybe he mentions that statement because in the Kune, I understand they would see a family remover. But it's quite clear that probably, maybe the technical staff are influenced as a player. So the club are trying to create a role for him as some part of the back room or anything. So that's what I'm saying, Wutsi. The players that we have developed, Tina's Tan Wutsi's even an emotional attachment and as long as hope, Wutsi Bazukula Bazukula. What you must share for me? Okay, just name them. Okay, I know you said three, but I mean five. Ukune, Vuma, Mashiane, Ngobo, Samkelo, Uban, Sabelo Khatir. We have to move on at some point. From those players, we have to move on. For the sake of the bench, we have to move on.
Yeah, go submit. And we're going to end it there. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Go check out Walter, Lapogu Touchline, and also go follow him on Twitter. I will put the link somewhere here. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Walter, for joining me.
Thank you, my brother, for having me.
Yeah, thank you so much for watching, and until next time, remember, Ikosi, and Pelumoya.